फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू ड्रॉ योर अटेंशन टू आर नंबर फॉर्मेटिंग टैब दैट फॉर्मेट सेल डायलॉग बॉक्स. हेयर यू हैव प्रोटेक्शन टैब. In your protection tab, you have two options, logged, hidden. By default, logged is checked all the time. That means it belongs to format cell. The cell you have selected, the option is for the single cell or the full selection. So, how to protect the sheet? Just right click on that sheet tab and from here you can protect your sheet. If you protect your sheet, you can have password here. Okay, I can type any password here and re-enter password. Now I have protected the sheet. I can't enter any text in that because let me unprotect that, because every cell is selected as logged. Suppose with VBA we are preparing a form here. And I want that user should enter in these cells only. The cells I have marked yellow. And the other cell will not be accessible to the user. I will go. What I will do this, I will select the three cells and press that number tab, and in protection I uncheck that logged. Now what will happen when I protect the sheet? I will protect this sheet with the password. Now I can't enter anywhere, but in these cells I can enter my values. Okay, I can't change value to anywhere else. Okay, so basically are all the cells are by default are locked. So to be accessible these cells while protection, we choose first let me unprotect the sheet because all the options are not available in that. So we choose this thing. Suppose I want to access this area only. What I will do that, I will press Ctrl 1 and uncheck this log. So this will be accessible when I will use protect sheet. Now outside I can't work, but it's inside I can give my range, give my values there. I can still, I can't enter value outside. Let's suppose I don't want user to select the cells here. Or data, what I whatever I have typed here, the user should not able to copy. See, currently if I use this protect sheet, in current position user can copy this cell and paste it to anywhere else. He can copy my sheet, but I don't want that user should copy my sheet, copy my these areas, some areas. So what I will do this, while protecting sheet, there are a lot of options. Allow all user of this worksheet to select log cell, select unlog cell. So I will make it off this option, select log cell. Now he will not be able to select these cells. I am clicking, but it is not going there. Okay. And if user cannot select the cell, he cannot copy that. My cursor is moving around to that position which are open. Suppose I have these three cells to be entered, and I select these cells and make it unlock, and I protect the sheet and don't want user to select log cell, then my tab navigation will be only on these cells, only on unlocked cells. Okay, like a software. And the logged data is also secure. Now I want to log some particular area and unlock all the sheet. So in that provision I want to log this area only. This area I want to be logged, rest of all I don't want. So first I will select all the cells, then go to this protection tab and make it unlock from here, press OK. Then I select the particular cell to which I want to log. I can choose log and OK. Now the setting is changed. Now these cells are logged only, rest of the sheet you can work anywhere. So I am protecting sheet, I don't want these cells to be selected. Now I can work anywhere, but not in this area. This area I can't select. Okay. So by that, by using this, you can create web some forms like you like software. This protection is based upon only one sheet. Your filtration option is off. There are your lot of options are off in this segment in protection method. Okay. Let us unprotect the sheet. Now this is only for one sheet. And suppose we have two types of we want to enter these data to be entered by different persons. I want that this data to be entered by this person and this data to be entered by this person. So we will create a range here. In the view tab, allow user to edit range. When these are locked, when allow user to edit this range, new, I will give the title here and the password for that. I have given different password here. Again, password. Okay. Then I select new and select this range, a new range with the different password. And apply. Now I have two ranges with different passwords. This area is logged. I protect the sheet. And when I click on this cell, first I have to make the selection here. Select logged cell. Now when I select this cell and I want to enter some data, it asks for password. When I will give the password, then only I will be able to write in these cells. Now for this person I have given one password and this person another password. When I click that area, it asks for password. So you can give user level protection through range by range. You can select a particular area for one user. Suppose in an organization hierarchy, you design a report where employee writes his performance appraisal, manager gives his comment. So you will use different password option for different level of officer. In a single sheet, you can give them password and ask for entering the data. So I can have password here. Now I can enter the data here. Rest of all, I can't change. Okay. So, we have known about protecting sheet and providing a special editing rights for different users. Now let's see protect workbook. When we do protect workbook, we have two options, structure and windows. When we protect structure, that means I can't insert the sheets, I can't rename the sheet, I can't delete the sheet. This will protect your structure in a workbook. This is called a workbook in which you have lots of sheets. This file is called workbook. So you have protected the workbook structure. That means you can't insert, update, delete, insert and delete sheet in the workbook. And when you protect your workbook with Windows, here you have sign for minimizing, restoring and closing the window. This will not show you here. You can't open different workbook in this window only. In Excel application, only one Excel sheet will work. Excel workbook, only one workbook will work only.
Darjin.
You have two options, structures and
buildings.
No, we have known about protecting sheet and protecting workbook. Now let's talk about file protection. Suppose we want a user should not be allowed to see the file without entering a password. So from where we will give the password, we will go in this. Suppose if you have not saved the workbook, while saving you have this tools here. In tools you have that general option, and in general option you can give your password to open and password to modify. Okay. Now I have saved the file with protect, the name of protect. Now if I open the workbook, it demands for password. And when it, after entering the password, it will open. Okay. Suppose you have saved your file. You have a file which you have saved earlier. Such as this one. Now, let's open any saved file. Now here you want to give password, then you have to use this office button, and in prepare you have encrypt document. Here you can give your password here. Now the file is password protected. If you open it, it will demand for password. Okay.
Yeah, what is the difference of this password protection of workbook and encryption?
Encryption is for file level. In workbook protection, you can't insert, delete sheets. But in file protection, you can't even see the file without entering password. You can't see the data. So this is the basic difference. Now, there is one more option there. There was one more option, like hidden. What is hidden? If you are using a too much complicated formula and you don't want user to see that formula. Suppose in this you have entered formula here, and the formula is visible in this option. Here in formula bar you can see the formula only. But if you don't want that user should see your formula, then you can make it hidden. Okay, and when you protect your sheet, the formula, it will not show the formula here. Okay,
but the data updated, suppose say we will give the formula in the next sheet, and formula we will give in this sheet. So if you change any data in the next sheet, automatically it will be updated even though it is protected.
Yes, the automatic functionality it will do, but the user interaction will be protected in that.
Okay,
so basically, so
suppose if we send this file Sandeep to anybody, then he will be able to format this or not, unless we put the password for that. He will not be able, right?
Yes, he will not be able to format the values. Suppose
format in the sense, he, can he see the formulas unless he puts the password?
No. There are three levels of protection. First is your sheet protection, in which you decide which cells to be worked with or not. The workbook protection is for that you can't enter any sheet, insert any new sheet, delete the sheets. And the third is file protection, that the file should not open without password. Just like that, there are three protections only. Then there are user level protections to give it, providing user different rights. You have different range, and you have given different persons different password, that that person only be able to work with this range. So you can do with that. So this is about Excel protection. One more thing, in Windows, if you want to lock your files in Windows, then you can only you can download that folder lock. There are lot of softwares like folder lock, you can lock there. And if you want to hide your file in properties, there is hidden. You apply this, the file will be hidden here. But when you want to again appear the file, then you go for, you select desktop from here, you press alt tab. When you press alt, then you then this file menu appear in your explorer. In folder options, in view, you can show hidden files or folders, or don't show hidden. Show hidden files or folders. Okay, then it will appear like hidden file. This file was like hidden. It is like transparent, so that means it is hidden. Now you can right click this and uncheck this hidden box, apply, it will appear again, and set your folder options like it was previous. Don't show it in time. Okay. Basically, this is all about protection. So, if you want me to continue with different or more things, I can continue with formula.
No, in the protection, can you showed this, what you called, when you are protecting the area, Can you just unprotect?
Which one?
Yeah, can you protect it now? Protect the some area.
Yes. You can provide the
Yeah,
right
here
amount.
the down a lot of stuff is there. Yeah,
Yes,
insert
sir.
the column. What is this? The rest of the things.
These are the rights for your users that after protecting the sheet, what he can do with this. If I select this format cell, then he can use that format cell option in protect sheet also, in protection mode also.
Okay, this is what we are allowing to the user, right?
Yes. Suppose one more thing I want to tell you, that sometimes we make some buttons with these options, these objects. We make our button with these objects. So when we protect these options, these objects are also not accessible. When we want these objects to be accessible in protection, while protection, then we need to do while protecting. Here we have edit object. Just check this and OK. Now you can use this thing also. Otherwise, you will not be able to use these buttons if we have made this as a button.
I think we need to
edit
I think we need to practice something, I think.
Yeah, this is being treated as a separate object, right? It's not a part of the sheet.
Yes.
So that's why if we want to lock it, we need to go in the options as you told right now.
Yes. We need to unlock it because it will be locked also in while protection. See, I am protecting my sheet and I am disabling this edit object. Now I can select this object. So for if I have made like button, then it needs to be selected. So we can use that edit option, edit object option, this one. Okay. Rest of the options will be locked in that, will not be able to use. There are a lot of options you can't use. Okay, sir. So just explore the options with protection and practice that. Do you want me to clear any anything else? Sir, the session is finished now for protection. You can ask your
okay,
questions
sir.
If you want. Otherwise, we can leave.
Yeah, I think we can leave today. So, what is tomorrow? We have a class?
Tomorrow, we will be doing some formulas because
okay.
In between, I will give the class to Naresh ji for rest of the classes. And from Monday, we will do something extraordinary things in Excel.
Okay, sir. No problem.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, Naresh.